That minute, bro. That minute. I know. I got 10 more days, and then I wish for it.
I feel weak, bro.
Honestly, man. I lost so much. Fucking Christmas over here.
Welcome back to my vlog. What's going on, guys? We're here at Outplay Gym. We're here with German.
Where
with Josh?
All I did was calisthenics.
You guys haven't seen Josh on the channel in a long time.
Calisthenics.
A long time. He got shipped out for the Air Force. He's back in town for 14 days. We're gonna crush a back workout. We're gonna take it through, take him through it, Coach Chad style. Josh actually used to be one of my clients before he got shipped out.
No, not yet.
So we're gonna take it back today. That's what we're gonna do. We're also gonna talk about individual differences between someone that is a beginner lifter, an intermediate lifter, and an advanced lifter. What training differences look like, what programming looks like, what you need to be mindful of going into each separate realm, and how to understand if you are a beginner, if you are intermediate, if you are advanced. So stick around to the end of the video. Drop a like for me. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. If you don't know who I am, my name is Chad Morgan. I'm an online fitness coach. I'm here to help you show up as a powerful, confident individual through your health, fitness, and mindset. And I also brush my teeth every day.
God. Hey, you're back in business.
Hello, or hi, Wish McCaw. It's Jim, your boy Jim. I'm finally back, you know, BMT, tech school, back for 14 days of leave before I bounced to Italy. So I had to get a lift in with my big bad Chad. You know, he's down with the thickness. He definitely got a lot huge, bigger than me now. So,
bro, wow, congrats.
I know.
And this guy,
congrats.
Two-time Mr. Olympia right here, all right?
Oh.
He came back. Dude, you added a crazy amount of size in your back. We'll put the transformation right here. Unbelievable, dude. How do you feel about that?
How do I feel? Well, I mean, just like, you know, I just had to grow the shell. I saw it, and I had to grow the turtle shell, you know, get my rose, you know. Back shit right there, you know what I'm saying? So it can't be no Titanic, so we can't sink. So, you know, just pull through, did your work, you know, kept the macros going in tight and all that stuff. And, you know, I did it, came through. All because of this guy. This guy motivates me.
Fuck yeah, brother. We're producing Olympian champions out here. Back like you never left. As we're performing the cable mid-row here, guys, there's a few different ways that you can perform this row. If you want to get more of a lower lat contraction, you're actually going to round your back a little bit and stay in a rounded position. So when you come forward, you're actually rolling your elbows out, and then you're pulling back in a circular motion down towards your waistline. That's going to activate a lot of your lower lats. For today's movement, we're doing more of a mid-row, so we want to be targeting, you know, the upper back, the middle back, lower trap, rhomboid, and rectus area. So the main goal of this is to come back to a 90-degree angle chest wall. So we want to bring our elbows back as far as we can. Less of a circular motion, more of a scapular contraction. So this is what it's going to look like, all right? First working set. 12. Hopefully I piss my pants a little bit. I sound like a big nerd, but like, I'm doing like rows and stuff, or any muscle group for that matter. I'm just like thinking and envisioning like know, what does my back look like on stage? You know what I mean? I fucking want it. Like, I really fucking want it. Like, that bad. I think about it all the time now. Every time I get in the gym, I'm like, shit, I'm going pro now. Like, I need to go pro. So, like, that's all I'm fucking thinking about. And then, I thought I was motivated on prep. Nah. Hey, dude!
Hey.
What up?
I came to say hi. What's up?
Oh, just we got single arm dumbbell rows. Essentially, here, guys, what we're really aiming to do is start a lot. Okay? You don't start a lot more like this. Okay? You push your fucking back into it. Why the goddamn back? You grab it. You know what I'm saying? That's like.
Open them up just like a surgery. Everything burning around me on lit. Show a little attitude, swap out the bitch. I spent 250, don't know where it went.
I don't know if you guys noticed, but the second that I started putting my hand on Josh's lower lat, he started bringing his elbow back around further, okay? He was more so in an upwards plane, and once I put his hand on his lower lat, he started bringing it down and around a little bit more. That's the main focus with this dumbbell row here, guys. You know, you want to be getting a middle back contraction, go do what we just did. We're focusing on the lower lat here, so look at Justin.
We can never be the same.
Diamond in the face. Pulling out ass to take a taste, little baby. Pulling out 50 racks, walking out of chase. If I drop dead, it'll be hard to replace. Hardly get thirsty, got water like a leak.
Show up, show up. Back out, pull up.
You don't care about fame, you just trying to get rich on the low.
Show up, show up.
See it's full of
blue. Back up, pull up.
Got him running. Running up, hitting up, sending up, hit him on impact. Pull up on scene, have him all looking, we stunned, no can I forget that. Got up on niggas, don't really man. Looking up and see who you want.
Bitch, I ain't
done
no engine. You
hit
with a boom. Me and Tay slide on it.
Let's do some examination. It's some examination here, okay?
Look from this angle.
Play for a reset. Alright, so upon further examination, as you see here, we're really hitting this rear delt. We're really hitting this portion of the lat right here, right? That upper portion, that real thick, meaty part right here, right? Kind of jiggling around. That's what we're going for. So, a well-rounded back day means well-rounded angles, okay? First off, we're hitting that middle back, that upper trap, that rhomboid area. And we're moving into the lower lat focus here when we go into that single arm row. Moving into the high row here, it's a lot of rear delt. It's a lot of upper lat thickness, right? And after this, we're going into a barbell row, which is more so overall. And then we're ending with a lat pull down, which is for overall lat lift. So everything's super well rounded. So when you guys go to design your programming for back training, make sure that you're hitting every single area, you know, pretty much evenly for a super well-developed back like that. God damn it. Alright, listen here, dude. I'm gonna tell you a secret. When you do this row, okay? I'm a victim of it. When it starts getting heavy, I wanna start hip hinging, right? I wanna start doing this with my hips. Start like doing what you should only do in the bedroom, not the fucking gym. So, right? You come up, you keep your hips stationary. and you just grow from pure strength, and you poke your chest out at the top to get a little bit of extra arch there for a little contraction, come back down and avoid pinching at the hips. Trust me, thank me later. You might have to go down in weight, but that's good. Not worth it. That's nice. Listen here, Apple. I have a significant amount of money invested into you, okay? These shits fall out of my ear. I know it's a working set when these fall out of my ear. Just my face goes like this and it falls out. I wanna know if there's hooks that go around them, because these sound and connect and just perform significantly better than power beats. They just don't stay in my fucking ear, man. I don't know what to do. I'm gonna invent my own fucking company. Call it Beyond Beats. You have no reason to do this, and I'll be talking about this later, but you have no reason to do this unless you're like in the later stages of intermediate lifting, which is where I am. Where we all are. Big end. Oh. What arm is your weaker arm?
My left.
I disagree.
Really?
Yeah.
I feel like my left one is fucking weak.
So when you're doing the bicep curl, naturally as it's getting heavier, your elbows are flaring out to get it up. And this right one is flaring a lot more. Yeah, so I don't think you necessarily need to go down. Just focus on like keeping your elbows tight up against your body, even as you're curling up.
Yannis.
Yannis. And focus on that right side a little. Alright fam, if you made it to this part of the video, this is the juicy part of the video, in a sense that this is going to be the most informative part of the video, right? We're going over, you know, the training differences between a beginner and an intermediate lifter and an advanced lifter. And I want you guys to be very, very honest with yourself in judging which of these categories you fall under. Now, starting with a beginner lifter is going to be someone that, you know, is someone that literally can go in the gym on pretty much bullshit structure, bullshit nutrition structure, and see rapid hypertrophy,
That's just the truth. When you first start getting in the gym, whether you're working out two, three, four times a week, you're going to literally put on muscle like it's nobody's business at front, okay? Even if you're in a hypocaloric state and you're someone that's trying to diet and lose weight, and you get yourself in the gym, you're gonna be putting on muscle very rapidly. Now, it will get to a point to where you plateau. When you hit that point to where you plateau, now you're moving more towards into intermediate. So as an intermediate lifter, an intermediate trainee, this is where you actually start needing to pay a lot more attention and start taking, you know, training more seriously, you know, diet more seriously, you know, introduce counting macros, be very, very mindful of fatigue management as well as overall progression in the gym. Start tracking your lifts, start tracking your macros. This is more the intermediate realm, which a lot of you guys that are watching this video right now. So as an advanced trainee, you'd literally need to be basically in control of every single variable at this point. Right now, across the board, I do recommend being in control of every single variable. At the end of the day, like, why not? You're going to be seeing most optimal and maximized progress by doing that. But when you're in this advanced realm, if you lose sight of hitting your macros, lose sight of hitting your protein, if you're eating in too small of a surplus, too small of a deficit, etc., you are going to hit a plateau. This is at a point where your diminishing returns are so high to where you really need to put so much effort into your overall training structure. You need to be super mindful of the details, right? The details don't so matter so much when you're just starting out, right? I'm always going to say that, but when you're getting more into the advanced training, you know, you might need to look and, you know, look at your fatigue management and say, hey, I need a deload. You might need to get to a point to where you're training beyond failure under, you know, towards the back half of a mesocycle. So when you're an advanced trainee, every single detail really does count. So guys, as a beginner trainee, I'm really talking to people that are really aiming to have this lean, built, you know, shredded, sculpted physique year round. At the end of the day, if you're just trying to get in shape for a wedding, you know, this doesn't really pertain for you. But I know for a fact that, like, people watching this video want to get to that point. Understand, guys, if you're a beginner trainee, you can get away with training 2, max 5 times a week, right? Now, I really want you to focus on compound movements, right? Your primary movers being compound movements. What compound movements actually allow you to do is build a fantastic baseline of strength, movement patterns. I mean, you know, you work on your stabilizing muscles and it builds that baseline strength to when you get more into the intermediate realm, you're gonna have a lot of strength. And I really want you to focus on technique. Technique is number one as a beginner athlete, okay? You don't want to be going in the gym, you know, bullshitting yourself, training beyond failure, maximum output if you have shitty form. That is a recipe to hurt yourself. And I think so many people get so discouraged very early on because they think that they need to try and train at maximal effort all the time. They think that they need to train 7 days a week and they get burnt out and they go, oh, fuck this training shit, I'm always beat up. It doesn't need to be like that. As a beginner, guys, your threshold for minimum, you know, minimum adaptive volume is so low that you can get away training up upper lower split, training a full body split, and literally training under 10 working sets per muscle group per week, and you will see a ton of growth stimulants week over week over week. Literally a beginner athlete, guys, you can probably put on a 5-10 pound margin on your, like, something like a barbell bench every single month, and that equates to literally 120 pounds on your barbell bench over a year if you're doing things right. And beginners are able to do that. You look at me, I'm not able to put 120 pounds on my fucking bench over a year, neither is Hanman, right? We're moving more towards that intermediate and advanced realm. So as a beginner, your threshold for gains is insane. So take advantage of that and don't overtrain. So for compound movements, the rep ranges is what you're probably thinking about. You know, focus on your compound movements being between 5 and 10 reps, right? You don't need to put yourself in a position to be training beyond 10 reps for those big movers because you want to get yourself used to heavier load, right? When you build that baseline of strength, not only are you just systemically fatiguing yourself by going way too high in the rep ranges, but you're allowing yourself to learn technique, learn form, learn etiquette, and build that baseline of strength. You can actually, you know, start off a training block with 5 reps in reserve and work all the way up to 2 reps in reserve. As a beginner athlete, there's no reason for you to be training at maximal output consistently. All right, so moving into intermediate style training, you know, this is where you want to start dabbling with 4 sessions a week up to 6 sessions a week, right? Start looking at training every single muscle group 2 to 3 times a week, right? You're now still focusing on your compound movements, right? There's no reason for you to just ditch the compound movements behind you, but this is where you can start introducing more isolateral work, you know, isometric work, you know, different more machines, different secondary movements, different tertiary movements, and you can add in more, you know, you can dabble in different movement patterns in the gym a little bit easier now, and you can actually use that 10 to 20 rep range for about, I would say 20 to 40% of the movements and that you're doing in the gym, you want to use that 10 to 20 rep range, and you're going to be moving more towards into, you know, hypertrophy. Now that you're seeing a lot more diminishing returns, you need to be more aware of what your recoverable volume is per week, right? So now looking at a training block over 4 weeks, you're maybe starting between 3 to 4 IR, and then towards the end of a block, you're moving towards 0 to 1. Not past failure, but 0 to 1 instead of 5 to 2 RIR. So, you know, you got to make training harder over time, coming from beginner, coming to intermediate, and this means you're bringing in more movements, right? You have that baseline of strength that you built up through technique, form, and strength with your compound movements from the beginner stages. You're moving now into the intermediate realm. You can't expect to be just packing on weight on the bar every single week, every single month, the same rate you were as beginner. So that's why you need to start adding in more reps, adding in more sets, and using volume and frequency as your measure for progressive overload. Moving into advanced training, guys, this is where you need to be real with yourself and ask yourself a question. If you actually haven't properly set yourself up for structure in this intermediate realm from both a nutrition standpoint and a training standpoint, utilizing RIR, utilizing, you know, progressive volume week over week, you're still intermediate, okay? Now, when you have spent so much time, you know, actually, you know, using proper structure, training, nutrition, and you hit a point to where, yo, I'm plateauing, I'm even deloading, I'm coming back, I'm still plateauing, you're moving towards an advanced trainee, and it's gonna be a lot harder for you to see the gains that you wanna see. So structure for an advanced trainee, guys, you're starting out a block with maybe 2 to 3, 1 to 2 RIR, and ending a block, you know, midway through the block, you're already at 0-1 RIR, reps in reserve. Moving towards the end, you're literally pushing yourself past failure. And that's why you'll see a lot of these pro athletes, you know, IFBB pro athletes training with coaches and pushing beyond failure at that point. You know, that's at the point where, you know, this athlete is, you know, more so an advanced trainee, and they've been training, you know, 7, 8, 9 plus years consistently under optimized nutrition protocols and training protocols. Now, advanced trainees are actually gonna use that 10 to 20 rep range for about 50% of their work in the gym, right? You know, this is at the point where they need to push volume and frequency a little bit higher to see that threshold of maximum adaptive volume week over week here. And they're focusing more on mind-muscle connection more than anything at this point. It's less about moving weight. And this is kind of what I've started to learn. And that's one of the biggest lessons that I've started to learn, you know, transitioning kind of from this intermediate to advanced realm now, is that mind-muscle connection is everything when it comes to bodybuilding at that point, right? When you get away with training with proper form and technique and etiquette and moving weight, yes, your muscle is going to build, but it's going to get to a point to where diminishing returns are there, and you literally need to be able to just control and contract every single muscle fiber the hardest you possibly can in order to stimulate that growth. So to conclude, guys, understand that, like, as a beginner, your threshold to grow is a lot higher than someone like me per se, right? If you're at a point right now to where you're hitting a plateau and you're not really pushing forward, understand that your answer is to actually get yourself under a proper structure. So I'm gonna invite you this, right? If you are wanting to apply for one-on-one coaching directly with me, I will leave my call booking link directly down below. You can schedule a call with me to chat about your goals, see if you're fit to join the program, or if you're saying, hey, you know, I don't need the check-ins, I don't need the one-on-one communication, I don't need the FaceTime calls, group calls, etc., I don't need the full customization. If you want to get under one of our structured training templates based off what your goal is, you can actually hit the link below that and sign up for our $25 a week coaching that's in our app in our Beyond Built Facebook group. And I want to share a few of these transformations with you guys, because looking back, it's really cool to see kind of my, like, older self in some of our clients. So this is a client, Stefan. He's been with us for 2 months now. Stefan's been able to put on over 10 pounds of muscle, and it's cool because this is someone that is kind of on the realm of transitioning from beginner into intermediate. He's now at a position to where he is intermediate. When he was, you know, he was on the cusp right when he joined the program. And it's cool because once we started adding in these new protocols, I mean, he's been packing on weight, pounds, and getting so much stronger. When he started with us, his bench, you know, for 4x6, this is 185, and now he's pushing 225 with ease. An example of this is also one of my clients, my first ever client, Steven, right? Steven was able to, you know, when he first joined the program, I mean, his deadlift was probably, I think it was 275, and I'll send some videos. I'll make sure that this guy sends you some videos, and he just pulled 500, you know, I mean, last year, right? And this is someone that's been working with me since 2019. So understand, guys, that, and you are a beginner lifter, you can make like huge jumps in your training. And when you get to the point where, for me per se, like I hit 315 bench once, it's gonna be hard for me to go into like 325, 345, 365. It's gonna be a lot harder. I'm gonna focus every single bit of my intention based around that. So if you guys are interested, two links down below for you. If this helped out, please drop a like on this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.